his body of us enough to call him. Then he the first one to try to rescue to help us get out of it, because he sees it causing trouble in our lives. See, God does not want my heart polluted. He wants my heart tender. Oh, God. God can do some wonders in a tender heart. You want to see God do wonders in every tender heart. Give a broken, contrite spirit. Let him find somebody who made a mistake but didn't like the mistake. Let him find somebody who went wrong but don't like wrong. Let him find somebody. He come to the rescue.
Yes,
sir. I said, here I come.
Yes, sir.
My God.
But if you like it, let's keep it.
Right.
Yeah.
Let the seal.
Come on, turn the light on.
The heart that is sensitive toward God often can be moved, touched, and not fully know what the real problem is. All that person knows, something is not right. I can't see you before you had that experience. You're about to do something. I was in the store the other day, had the money in my pocket, going to buy me something. And I heard the Holy Ghost say, don't do that. Guess what I did? I went right back to where I got it, put it on that shelf, as neat as I could, and got up out of there. It was on sale, too. But he said, I didn't need it. I seen him do that before. I went into the store one time to get some trousers. I looked at these trousers, and it was about, back then, it was about $45. You know, I had them in my basket on Wednesday. Put them back. I put them back and went to Jackson, Mississippi and bought me 3 pairs of less than one pair of clothes. And I'm still wearing them. Boy, if you listen, you can learn. If you learn, you can do it. If you do it, you come out on the top. Hallelujah. See, sometimes you and I, and see, some of us are going to go back to smoking, drinking, going and so on. We just be lazy. And sometimes we just get cold on the Lord. Hold on too long and say, now, you know you're not as excited about me as you once were. You notice there was a time when you were part of what's going on. Now you just watching what's going on. He's trying to get my attention. If you don't like it, Lord, I'm so sorry. Apologize. That's all he wants to do is apologize. Lord, I'm so sorry that I allowed myself to get as cold as I am. Let me tell you all something. Don't tell anybody I told you this. When a believer waxes cold, he or she opens the door for things that otherwise would be rebuked. There's no more loose here, get behind me when you get cold. It's dangerous to get cold on the Lord. Keep going. I don't mean any harm. Any of you preach today. Practice this. That's up to you. You watch me, you'll never catch me as broken. Lift a hand, get an order, high five, say amen. You can sit on your hands if you want. I'm not going to do that.
I love it, Bishop.
I don't like homemade stuff.
No.
My mother was a strong influence over me. She was a 100% illiterate woman, never attended school, not one day in her life. She was born in 1898, never attended school one day in her life. But my mother had some stuff that some of the folks went to school didn't have. She asked you to do something for her. If you know, you're broken like you. She'd say, she get up and do it herself. I got my people up, man. And I believe the Lord is like that. Let's give him a praise. If you got to ask somebody to give him a praise, is it really a praise?
Come on,
Bishop.
Come on. That's good.
Right. Or is that person doing like a parakeet? Repeat what he or she heard.